So Sergey, big news. You're fighting Omar Figueroa. Oh, yeah. It's big.
Oh, yeah.
First of all, I want to wish Adrian Broner the best. Adrian Broner is going through a very hard time right now.
I hope he's be well.
Hopefully, and I want to see him fight again soon. He's a good person, Adrian. You know him? Ever meet him?
No, no.
Very nice guy.
Yeah.
Good person, great fighter, but...
I never saw him, I never speak, I don't know.
You just wish him the best.
Yeah.
So you're very brave.
Boxing is very tough sport.
The hardest. ESPN did a study. Out of 50 sports, they said boxing hardest.
And boxing business very tough.
Very hard.
Not only sport and business too.
It's not easy. Not the sport, not the business. So Omar Figueroa, you're fighting him. 5-day notice.
Yes. Actually, we know, they told me before what it's, I need to be ready if somebody is thinking, they can lose weight or something else, you can change somebody.
So your opponent may change.
Yeah, and your opponent may change, and I need to be ready for Broner or Figueroa or somebody other. And it's funny with a different guy, different style, you know.
Every day, different look. So, Omar Figueroa style, come forward, throw punches. You like that?
Yeah.
He does not gonna run.
Oh yeah.
The fight. Do you think you knock him out?
We will see how's it going. We're ready for everything, you know.
Do you think he knocks out Omar Figueroa?
You try him with him.
Oh, that's his style. It's come forward and let it. Oh, he's not gonna become a boxer overnight. Justin likes the fight.
Yeah, everybody I think likes the fight. And I like fight. He's no run, I don't will run. And I will show old school boxing.
Let your hands go. You're smiling even though you're making weight. It's not easy. 140 not easy or easy?
It's not easy.
Nothing's easy in boxing.
No, I'm happy because I have good fight. And I'm a minivan.
Big opportunity, you're headlining.
Yes, and I'm no fight. 1 year and a half. I think very hard. I wait, you know, 3-4 opponents change, and we work and no give up, and hard work pay off.
You know what's crazy? When I first met him, he couldn't say one word in English. Now his English is better than mine. Good job, Sergey. Your English got really good. How did you learn English?
I speak with everybody. I try.
Cartoons.
I try.
You watch a lot of TV,
next
a lot of movies?
Next time I will have like this.
Australian accent?
Now it's a heavyweight accent.
Oh, Joshua Usyk. What do you think, Sergey? Joshua Usyk. Why?
Why?
Yeah.
Just like last time.
Peter! До свидания, пока.
You know, it's if Joshua change something, is start work like Mexican, go forward, no give space for Usyk, he can win because he's bigger.
Too strong. He likes the power. Justin, what'd you say? Okay, we couldn't hear you. We couldn't hear you.
And Josh got the best chin. He's 6,000.
Yeah, but chin doesn't matter if you hit hard before you get hit.
There's the big, the magic thing.
Okay. So Sergey, you're fighting at 140, right? Teofimo Lopez 140. Ryan Garcia 140. Adrian Broner when he comes back at 140. Regis and Zepeda one fight. A lot of big fights for you at 140 if you beat Omar Figueroa. I like, who do I like? You and Teofimo?
I don't think about it.
Nobody, just Omar.
First, I need to win Omar.
Yeah.
After, We need fin, speed, and everything else. First work, after top.
I like that. He's focused. But it's crazy to take a fight on a 5-day notice. Even if you knew there was a possibility, he said they told him you may be a replacement just in case.
Because maybe, but we were always preparing to fight on the card anyway. So, you know, we were going to fight. We were supposed to fight for the chair. It was an easy changer.
Well, ever since COVID, they always had the replacement.
Portillo was actually a little more awkward to fight. Then
so Figueroa is a better fit, better style.
Yeah, it's a good fight to this. Figueroa's coming to fight. He always does. Never taken lightly. So,
you know. One thing I was surprised, Figueroa, I did an interview with him and he talked about mental health for 10 minutes. And then he thought Broner's faking it. You can have it both ways. You either support people or you don't say something.
You start saying shit like you got mental health, you're in the boxing business, get the fuck out.
A lot of fighters are going through it, Justin. Ryan, Danny, Teofimo.
20 years ago, no one had fucking mental health conditions in boxing.
Maybe they did.
Man, yeah, when they shut the fuck up and stopped bitching. Jesus. Nobody wants to fucking hear about, oh, my mental health problems. Yeah, we got fucking millions. Shut the fuck up.
Money doesn't affect anxiety and depression.
You're doubting yourself that much, leave boxing.
Listen, I love Broner. I want to see him come back. I want to see him do good. He's a good dude. He's a good person, Justin. Really, he is.
No, I understand. Bruno is smart enough to say, you know what? I have a feel good in the head. I'm out.
Smart? Yeah, why go in there? Because the fans don't care.
They don't. But he's smart enough to say, I'm out. Similar to that. They didn't sit there and bitch about all this and that. They would never make excuses. He said, my health is more important. That's my decision. Good luck to him. And that's smart. Well, I got this problem, I got that problem.
One thing I will say, and I'm going to tell all the people watching this, Sergey is hitting harder right now than in the past. Yeah. I hear it. Do you feel it? You hit harder now, Sergey?
Yeah.
He hits like, he said you hit like a heavyweight.
I said he's not.
But you're hitting harder. Why do you, explain it to me. Why are you hitting harder now? You always had good power.
Because change training, we have more excess for explosion,
balance.
You know, he's a good coach, conditioner coach.
I gotta ask you a question. It's a good team. You're the only Russian fighter that I know that smiles. Why is that? No, seriously, tell, what are the Russians you know that smile?
Because I lived too long in Los Angeles.
Okay, you became, you've been too much in Hollywood, huh? Think about it. Tell me what Russian fighters, boxing or MMA, that smile. They don't, they're always... But Sergey smiles, he's always happy. You have your friends?
Yeah.
Representing Kazakhstan, Moscow,
Russia,
Australia, Russia, everywhere.
Australia, Kazakhstan, Jerusalem.
That's it.
Your,
Jerusalem, representing, putting in work. You're going to warm up right now, but you're happy.
You know, weight go down.
Your sparring partner just left. I scared him up.
No, I want you to have his,
yeah, weight's coming down. You're happy. You look on weight almost.
Yeah.
He's headlining on Showtime Saturday.
I know. I'm excited, but I can't wait. Miami.
Omar Figueroa. What do you tell Omar?
Be ready to go out and... I know he's make weight like me, and we don't have fight. We same from 147 go down in weight, and it's very hard. And I support him. I hope he support me for lose weight.
You support him, you love him, but you want to knock him out.
Of course, it's a business, you know. When we're out in the ring, we're not friends, nobody. Yeah. We hit each other, that's it. It's a boxing.
By the way, Sergey.
After fight, we're all together, you know.
Yeah. Were you can start working out. Were you surprised when you got the call and they said, hey, you're fighting Omar, or you were not surprised?
Yeah, I'm surprised.
You didn't expect it? 5 days to go.
Yeah, because it's a 7 day.
But it's better 5 days than the day of the weigh-in, or better to prepare 5 days before than the same day?
I don't know, maybe it's better than they say, oh, you tomorrow you fight with the girl.
You think
and you are in a rush, you know, think about it.
You just fight.
Yeah, just fight. And it's for me, it's no matter. I'm ready for everything. I am training hard. I have good body partners. I have three body partners for 12 rounds. And every day they come like two or three body partners.
I've been watching you. You've been hitting hard. Very hard. The fans are going to see something special.
I hope. Fans like what I show, what I will show on Saturday.
Yeah. Did you see Teofimo's fight?
Actually, no.
I didn't. Ryan Garcia 140, Teofimo 140, Javante Davis 142.
Yeah, everybody go up.
Good division.
140, I go down 140. Good fights for fans, and I hope I wanna. Fight with the best, you know. I never scare someone, never tell what I'm fighting, never take fight. I fight, I take fight.
Sergey Lipinets, you became a world champion, 140 in 14 fights, right?
13 fights.
13 fights became a world champ. He has about 500 kickboxing fights with maybe
yeah,
five losses.
Kickboxing.
Yeah, work, a professional, amateur, everything.
Amateur, yeah, and after I'm going boxing, and for 3 years, 13 my fights, I win the title.
Yeah, amazing. It's very hard to do. The 140
I
champion.
Never
no time to waste. So tune in to Showtime Saturday night. Adrian Broner, not available to fight, is dealing with mental issues, wishing Adrian Broner the best. Omar Figueroa thought Broner is faking it or he wants proof, but you don't need proof. When people say they're sick or they're dealing with stuff, you have to believe it. Have to. And it's going to be fireworks. Sergey Lipinets stepping in on a 5-day notice. Who does that on a 5-day notice? Very few people. By the way, you like those gloves? Old school. The thumb, you could poke
it. Start training kickboxing.
Yeah.
In my city, they have same gloves.
From 1940,
1950. I don't know, but it's here. It's
and you can sell it on eBay. It's antiques.
And I train it when I'm doing gloves.
So there you have it, guys. Sergey Lipinets heading to Florida any moment to face Omar Figueroa, stepping in for Adrian Broner on a 5-day notice. And I've been watching him in camp, this whole camp, and he's been hitting extremely hard. So it'll be interesting to see if Omar could take Sergey's power. Stay tuned. Ellie Segback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Segback. You can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Segback. And you can follow Sergey Lipinets at Sergey Lipinets. And follow Fortune Gym at Fortune Boxing. Ellie Segback reporting. Ellie Segback reporting for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Segback reporting. ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Segback reporting.